Hello and welcome back. I've been very busy building the sweet farm on the Solitary Haven survival server. I have a couple farmer villagers who tend the field all day and can sleep in the little house at night. The farmers will leave the wheat and seeds on the ground once their inventory is full. It's then picked up by a minecart under the ground and deposited into the water mill on the right. Using my Aeris device, I have a lot of storage hidden underground with chests at the top for easy access. I'll put a link to the download below if you want to check it out. I started by flattening a medium-sized area and built a two-high fence around the field. Hopefully, this will keep pillagers from shooting my villagers, but I'm not sure if it's completely safe. Spiders do occasionally climb over the fence and break the crops, but they pose no real threat. I tried to make this look natural and avoided building a big rectangle. I added a third layer of fence on the back to protect them from mobs standing on the hill behind it. I also built a little house with a couple beds attached to the field so my villagers can go to sleep. This will prevent them from wandering all night and hopefully reduce the lag. I placed slabs every 8 blocks where the water will eventually be to hydrate the crops. I added trap doors under the slabs to keep the water from breaking the rails below it. Once I had everything planned out, I dug down 2 blocks below the ground. Then add the rails going east to west to cover the entire field. If you go north to south, the tracks won't line up at all. I placed a row of redstone torches with powered rails on top going down the center to keep the cart moving. You may need more powered rails if your field is larger than this. I dig out 2 blocks below each water source so I can place the rails under the trap doors. Otherwise, the cart would get stuck here. At the end of the track, I add a final powered rail so the cart will turn around and move back to the starting point. I add some rails under the dirt path and up into the water mill. I add an item collector at the end, which will hold the cart here until the hopper below it is empty. Then the cart is sent off again to collect more wheat. I surround this with solid blocks so baby zombies can't get under the farm and mess up the minecart. I've connected this output to a row of hoppers so I can add the item filter below it. Now I can cover the tracks with dirt and add water above the slabs. I also added some composters above the water to convert the villagers into farmers. Make sure to place slabs above them so the villagers can't jump on top and break the crops when they jump back down. Then I tilled the area and planted a couple stacks of seeds. This is more than enough to get started since the farmer will plant seeds in the rest of the field. I moved a villager into the farm and as expected, he claims the composter and starts tending the crops. I noticed that he's a bit slow, so I will be adding more farmers at some point. Since the bread-making mechanic is broken, I don't have to worry about losing any wheat. In the water mill, I build a standard item filter with overflow protection for the wheat, seeds, and bone meal. I added an additional row of hoppers to the item filter so I can route the overflow of seeds and wheat into a composter to make the bone meal. Then, if that is full too, the excess will flow into a dropper to be incinerated by the lava. Underneath, I added around 20 double chests and hoppers for each item. I feel like this will be more than enough storage, but you never know. At the bottom, I build the signal receiver, which will activate the droppers and fill the top chest. The droppers are turned off once the chests are full. You can check out my tutorial for the Aeris system if you want more details. Now I can mine out the tunnels used to transport the items back up. I build them straight up to 6 blocks above the top of the item filter. I pour a bucket of water at each opening so it flows into the chambers. I dive down and plant kelp all the way up, which converts the flowing water into source blocks. Now I can break the kelp and place my soul sand at the very bottom, which makes a column of bubbles to the surface. At the top, I add hoppers to collect the items connected to a row of double chests. I place a comparator and observer over these dispensers, which will send the signal down when more items are needed. Now that everything is functioning properly, I can finish the outer build. I added the water wheel first, low enough to be partially submerged in the river. This would be used to grind the wheat into flour for baking, but of course, in this case, it's purely cosmetic. I add some fence around the center point and surround it with dark oak stairs and planks. I made a cap on the end from cobblestone stairs to keep the wheel in place. I think it looks pretty good. Then I made a fairly simple roof over the water mill, starting with an overhang of dark oak stairs. I built a peak over the front door and added another one across from it on the back. Then I built the last peak over the water wheel, which is just tall enough to cover the pipe in the center. The water did spill out as I replaced the sides, but it did not cause the system to break. I connected the three to make a T shape along the top. Then I filled the rest of the roof with spruce stairs. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I would love to hear what you think of it. I've put some links below if you want to see more adventures on Solitary Haven. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.